Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading The Little Mouse Mitata, which I bought right here at Gaboff's Premium Wares in the Ark Nobles Quarter. A long time ago, in the Undercity, there lived a little mouse called Mitata. She was born there and lived a pale and bitter life in those damp and foul caves. One night, her disturbed sleep gave her a strange vision. Bright light, fresh air, and a lovely warmth surrounded her. She looked up and saw beautiful houses beneath a blue sky. This had to be the surface, the city of Ark. A place without misery, without the poor and sick lying on the streets, a place with enough food for everybody. But how could she get there? The dream gave her an answer. She just had to follow the main street throughout the large cave, up and further up, and not pay attention to those wondering about her ways. Behind an old wooden gate, she would finally reach the surface. After waking up, she dreamed a bit further on, and finally decided to follow the path shown in the vision. Why live in filth, in fear of disease and starvation, when there is a life of light and prosperity at the surface? On the next day, she made some final preparations, ate all the food she still had, and then left. She remembered a lot of her way well, and knew where the evil rats were lingering around, waiting to rob travelers. Over stones and crates, ropes and ground, she silently ran. The surroundings were familiar, yet disgusted her, and she couldn't form a clear thought until she reached a split of the street, beyond which she never walked before. She wasn't exactly sure which path to take now, so she looked around and found an old mouse sitting in an open barrel, gnawing on a piece of old cheese. "Excuse me, but do you know in which direction I can find the gate to the surface? Which path do I have to take?" The old mouse turned around, looked at her with a bitter face, and said, "What are you looking for at the surface, little mouse? It is dangerous and deceiving there, and they will catch you and throw you back here anyway." He paused for a moment, looked at the ground, and continued, "But why should someone like me stop a young mouse from pursuing her dreams? Follow the lanterns on the right side, and fall prey to the rats. That would truly be a shame." Confused, and not without doubt, Mitata thanked the old mouse for the advice and left to the described path. She passed by a few lone rats unnoticed until she finally saw the wooden gate. Enthralled, she ran towards it, the images from her vision rushing through her mind, when suddenly a group of armed rats stepped out of the shadows to the left to block her way. "Oh, look! A little mouse! Where are you running to so quickly, huh? Running for the surface? Really?" The rats laughed at her. With a quiet and shy voice, Mitata answered, "Yes, I want to go there. I dreamed of the surface, of the beautiful city. Yes, I want to go there." Once more the rats laughed. After a moment of tense silence, the fattest of the rats spoke. "Come on, guys. Let's not waste our time on this weak and delusion mouse. If she wants to run to those nobles up there, she'll learn her lesson soon enough." Ashamed and anxiously, Mitata left for the gate, still hearing the rats laugh at her dream. Then she slipped through a hole in the gate and finally saw the surface. The evening sun cast a warm orange light all over Ark, and the stones beneath her feet were still warm. A waterfall rushed down besides the myriad platform. The flavor of good and rich food filled the air, and the people outside of a nearby tavern laughed out loudly and happily. But Mitata did not understand any of this. She was just in awe of this beautiful sight, and tears of happiness filled her eyes. Then she walked to a clear pond, drank some fresh water, and cleaned herself in a puddle to the side of it. Just as she had dried her fur, another mouse approached her and asked, "Where do you come from, little mouse?" "From the Undercity. I just arrived here. It is so beautiful here. You know, I can't just understand. I—" Again she teared up, purely out of joy. The other mouse began to laugh, smiling. "Oh, this is heartwarming. A little mouse from the Undercity actually came up here. Then I'll boldly welcome you in the name of all citizens of the city of Ark. But maybe I should also explain some things to you, as living together in a society is very different here than in those filthy caves down there." And thus the mouse explained all the important rules to Mitata. She spoke of the path and the gods, of the fate, and the role of everybody in such a society, of the duties with respect to the wealth of everybody. Quickly, Mitata understood the requirements for a well-ordered society and how to maintain it. Since she had a lot of knowledge about criminal scum of all sorts and their tricks, she soon found work as a guard in a bakery. Again and again, disgraceful mice tried to steal food, the product of hard work of others, disregarding any moral values. Every day she went on patrol and searched for secret entrances and intruders. And as she did a good job at this, the criminal mice soon avoided the bakery, and the baker paid her appropriately. Also, he promised that as long as she led a path-abiding life, she would be welcome any time, and that there would be a warm place to stay and something to eat for her. This way, Mitata now lived in safety and security under the watchful eyes of Malthus and his statue carved into the temple rock. There was one thing, however, she couldn't understand. Why does almost nobody do what she did? Why did so few leave the Undercity without bad intentions? Ark was a welcoming city, and whoever went here with good intentions and with the will to do honest and hard work could live here so much better than in the Undercity. Thus, she prayed to Malthus every day so he would send dreams to many others in the Undercity, just as he had sent a dream to her, to ignite hope and will. With this dearest wish at the bottom of her heart, she lived on in Ark to the end of her days. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal, The Little Mouse, Mitata.